Hello, this is Jonas. In this video, I will present the test interface generator tool from VHDLwhiz and show you what it can do for you. So when I create VHDL projects, most of the time I have the need to access some internal registers in the FPGA in the lab from my computer. And we have different ways to do that. We can use AXI if we're using a processor on the FPGA, or we can use the tools like signal tap in Quartus or integrated logic analyzer virtual input output in Xilinx Vivado. But I think those are overkill because most of the time I just want to have a script on my computer that can write and read values. And we already have a UART port on most of the boards, so why don't we just use the UART for that? And that's what this script does. It will generate a custom VHDL module with specific input and output registers that you can use to access registers in your FPGA. For example, if you are reading sensor data, you can create an input register that is the width of the sensor data just by using this script. And if you want to send some commands, for example, the angle and velocity, you can create two registers for that by using the script. And then you can use that module and instantiate it in your design. So I'm going to show you an example of how we can do this for the RTS7 board's peripherals. So we can access the peripherals on this board by using the test interface generator and also some internal registers in the FPGA. I have already unpacked the zip file containing the interface generator to this folder, so let's have a look to see what's inside. We see these files and folders, and let's start at the one at the top, demo. This is a folder containing three demo projects for how to use this tool. I have generated three different interfaces for three different boards, and we're going to have a look at the RTS7 demo in this video. But first, let's look at the other folders and files. The RTL folder contains three VHDL modules that I have written, and you have to include them in your VHDL projects if you're going to use the interface, because the generated VHDL module that you will instantiate depends on these modules. So just include them in your VHDL project and it will compile. And then we have the generator script itself. This is a Python script. We're going to look at this in a few moments. The license file and the user manual. So I recommend you look in the user manual because there's a lot more information about how to use this script in the user manual. And there's also information about how you can use it in your own scripts if you don't want to use the command line interface. And there's also going to be a video in the membership portal which has more information than this video, where I go through this script in more detail, because this video is just a demo of what you can do with it. So when you join the membership or purchase this product, you will get access to that video. Okay, so let's right click here and open this folder in VS Code. So here we see the files to the left, and I'm going to go ahead and run the script, python gen uart regs.py. So that's the script you have to run. And then we see a short usage description, an error message, no registers were supplied, at least one register must be specified. So we have to specify which register we want to create. And we see here some hints for how to create them, but we can get more help by using the dash h flag, which will show the help menu. And what we have to do is to include the register name, the length in bits, the mode that's in or out, and the type. And we have some more options here that we can use, and there are also some examples listed here below. But we're going to go ahead and jump right in and start creating an interface. For example, for this board that I have here, the RTS7 board, there are some buttons and switches, so let's go ahead and start interfacing them, create an interface for this board. And we can start with the buttons. There are three buttons here, so let's name the new signal BTN, and it's going to be 4 bits long, and it's going to be an input of type standard logic vector. And standard logic vector is the default type, and in is the default mode, so we can just leave it like this. Other types are unsigned, signed, or standard logic, and other modes are out. So it can be out or in. If it's an in signal, it means that we can only read it. If it's an out signal, it means that we can also change the value of this VHDL signal over UART. Okay, so watch here, there's nothing named generated here at the moment. So I'm going to run this command. And now we see there's a new folder here, generated. And the script prints out the name of the register that we specified, BTN, the bit length, the type, and the mode is an input signal. Then it has generated three files. We can have a look at some of them here. The uartregs.vhd file is the module you have to instantiate. Let's open it and have a look at it. So here's the entity that you have to instantiate. It has the regular clock and reset inputs, the UART input and output, and also a block of signals here, currently only one, but we see the comment here says UART accessible registers. So this is the name of the register we specified, BTN for button, and it's a standard logic vector, which is the default type, an input, which is the default mode, and 3 down to 0, so it's 4 bits wide as we specified. So how about if we want to generate an interface to more signals? For example, we have some switches here. Let's include them. SW equals 4, because there are 4 switches, and then it's going to be an input. Let's specify that explicitly, and then we can make it assigned type instead of a standard logic vector. So let's run that. Then we see it lists those registers here, and the code changes. Now we have the switches and the buttons. But what if we want to control some outputs? We can do that as well. Just add some outputs, some LEDs, for example, equals 4, because we have 4 LEDs on this board. It's going to be an output of type unsigned, for example. Let's make it an unsigned. Okay, so when we hit enter now, we can see it has added the LED output and the other signals are still here. So it generates a custom interface for your inputs and outputs as you need, and you can specify the exact composition of this interface from the command line. And what about if we want to add some more signals that were internal signals? We can do that. We can have as many signals of any length as we want. For example, if you want to have a signal named reg0, it's going to be 40 bits wide. It's going to be an input of type signed, for example. We can generate that too. Now we have a 40 bit vector here. What if we want one more? Reg1. And let's make this really wide, 119 bits. So the width can be any number of bits. It doesn't have to be a multiple of 8. And let's make this an output of type standard logic vector. And there we see the new signal has been added to the interface. So all that you have to do when you are happy with this interface module is to instantiate it in the project that you're working on, where you want to control the signals and connect these signals to the signals you want to monitor and control. And there's also an instantiation template here for that. So with the VHDL module, it also generates instantiation template with the UART accessible signals as regular signals that you can copy and paste if you need them, and also the instantiation template. So this is what you have to copy and paste in your VHDL project where you want to monitor the internal registers or control them. And that is what I have done in this demo project. So I have a demo project here for the Xilinx S7 board. Let's go ahead and open the top module here. We can see I have created an interface for the peripherals on this board, and also some internal registers. We can see the comment here shows which Python command I used to generate it. And this is really all that is in this top module for now, except for the top level entity and the signals. We only have instantiated the module that I generated using the Python script. So I have it loaded and compiled and implemented in Vivado now. We're going to program the board. The board is not programmed yet. I'm going to click program here and program, and now we can see the done signal has been illuminated. This means that the board is programmed and we're ready to start interfacing it. And the good thing about this interface is that it creates a custom Python script for interfacing it. So in the generated folder, it created the instantiation template, the module itself, and a custom script for accessing this custom interface module. I'm going to show you how to use it now. We're going to go into the demo folder, into the Xilinx RTS7 folder, and here we can see there's a UART regs.py script, which is the one that was generated along with the interface module I created for this demo. So let's go ahead and run it. Python UART regs.py. So this is a different Python script, a Python script that was generated specifically for this interface. So when you use the gen UART regs.py script, it will generate the VHDL code, an instantiation template, and also this custom Python script for interfacing it. So if I run the script, we see an error message here because you have to specify what you want to do, read, write, or just list the registers. Let's look at the help menu here. And here's everything you can do in detail. I'm going to show you now. We can give the L flag to list the registers. And now it doesn't really reach out to the board. It just lists the registers that it knows about. Because this script now has information about the exact composition of your registers. So these are the registers that I created when I made this interface. The buttons, the switches, LED, color LED, and some internal registers. And if we use the dash R flag, we can read over UART. So now the board is connected through UART here. I'm going to hit enter now, and now we see it read the interface. It read all of the registers, and most of them are zero, except for this one. Switches, -8, because we made it assigned type. We see the hex value here. So that's because one of the buttons here is turned on. Like that, if I turn it off, we read 0. So if I turn on all of them, it should read 0F, right? And it does. And in sign, that means -1. Okay, so let's press some buttons here, for example. Press some buttons. And now we can see the button value here, hexadecimal 5. And we can also control the outputs. For example, the LEDs here. We see there's a bunch of outputs here. I'm going to control the LEDs, write something to them, and then we use the dash W flag. The name of the register is LED, and we can set it to a value specifying in decimal or hexadecimal or even binary. Let's use binary notation. Set it to 1010, like that. So now we see two LEDs are illuminating. If we change the number here, 0101, we see it changes, and we can read back the registers as well. So now we see the LEDs have changes. I specified that this was going to be an unsigned, so it also shows the integer value as an unsigned. Okay, so let's see if we can control these signals. These are discrete signals going to a color LED here. Let's try to write to them. We can write to one or several the same time. Let's write to the red equals 1 and the green equals 1. So what is red and green? Is it going to be a different color? I don't know which color red and green mixes to. Apparently yellow or something like that. And we can write to multiple registers at the same time or only one. And it changes all of the outputs at the same clock cycle. So you get complete set, and when you read, you get the complete set also. It samples all of the registers on the same clock cycle. So now let's turn this LED into a white LED by writing to all of the color components, and that worked. Okay, so we have some other internal registers here that are larger. For example, this 40-bit register. Let's try to communicate with that. Reg number 3 is the name here. So I'm giving that as the name of the register, and I'm going to set it to 1234 as decimal, just a random value. And if we read it back, we can see it has the integer value 1234. We can set it to a much larger value, 1234567789, like that. And that works too. It has updated the value, but if the value becomes too large for this 40-bit register to handle, the script will print out an error message. This value for register number 3 exceeds the 40-bit length allowed for unsigned. So the script converts the value to binary and finds out if it fits into the boundaries you specified, and if it doesn't, it will alert you. So now if we read back the registers, it will be untouched. And that concludes my presentation of this new tool that's available in the VHDLwhiz membership. I know that I'm going to be using this script a lot because I often have to create lab test interfaces for VHDL projects, and until now I have been creating them for each VHDL project, but with this script I can easily generate them for every single project without having to code the interface from scratch. You can purchase this tool from the VHDLwhiz shop, which I will link to from the video description in case you're not already watching this video on the sales page. And I also want to let you know that the tool is also available in the VHDLwhiz membership. The VHDLwhiz membership is a subscription-based VHDL and FPGA training program where you get a new learning or resource item every month. So every other month is going to be a course about something that has to do with VHDL and FPGA design. And the month between is going to be a resource item just like this one. And if you join the membership now, you can access this resource item and many others, and also many courses about VHDL and FPGA design today. And I'm going to link to that also from the video description. Okay, that was all for now. See you in the next video.